It's like Christmas right here. People driving by looking at the graffiti.
One day after this gang graffiti attack marred a Sacramento neighborhood, the taggers were back out there, and now residents are very concerned.
They woke up today to see that vandals had tagged a brand new bridge again near Northgate and El Camino Avenue, but this time, this extended to their property, their homes, fences, and the alleyways. KCRA3's Suzanne Fahn joins us now from our newsroom with more. Suzanne?
And Edie, neighbors believe that gangs are tagging areas and that rival gangs are spray painting over it, and now the graffiti is spreading.
Like I said, I'm tired. I'm tired of this.
Pete Delgado is exhausted from vandals spray painting his neighborhood and now spray painting his property. Days ago, vandals targeted this new West El Camino Avenue bridge with gang graffiti.
Yeah, now it's right here in front of us.
And just last night, neighbors say more graffiti showed up on their property.
It's getting bad. It's getting bad where they're coming back and forth, tagging up street to street. Now they're tagging garages. As you can see, fences, the front of my fence.
Neighbors believe it's turned into a gang graffiti war.
We're going from black to red to lime green now. It's been on and off for the last week and a half or so. It's got real bad.
If you have gang graffiti on your property, Sacramento Code Enforcement says you have 72 hours to remove it. If it's not gang graffiti, you have up to 10 days. Now, if you don't have the money to remove it, Code Enforcement will give you the materials.
I think it's terrible. I really do.
Delgado is upset at this courtesy note from the city. He thinks the city should be cleaning up the mess.
I think it's stupid. I think it's wrong. Completely wrong. Why should I go in there and do their dirty work?
And we contacted the Sacramento Police Department about the graffiti issue. They say that it's up to Public Works as well as Code Enforcement to handle it, as well as the Graffiti Task Force. Now, our calls have not been returned. Live in the newsroom, Suzanne Fahn, KCRA 3 reports.